Okay, here we are over at Sequoia Park in Monterey Park. If you could see, we have some pretty clear skies, except for the cirrus clouds. So, yeah, come on down.
Hey, this is Jay Lee. Hope all is well. I just wanted to touch on a couple of points on our UFO sighting event on the 29th of December over at Sequoia Park. Although the day before was incredibly beautiful, this day started off extremely cloudy. Personally, I like semi-cloudy days, but I've seen Fausto Perez go out on a cloudy day with some friends and see him just below the clouds. It's just incredible. So I'd say we saw about 7 objects this day. There were wave after wave of clouds flying over our heads. The clouds were coming from the northwest and heading southeast. I would say the entire time we had about 2 hours of open sky time. And just to let you know that I tried my best to capture these objects so that you could see them. But on this day, it was horrible for me. They were either moving too fast for me to capture and moving away from us, or they were getting lost in the clouds. So this is something else I'd like to talk to you about today. How high are these objects? Well, on a day like this, they make it easy. So before I show you the only thing that I did end up capturing this day, I wanted to show you this. I would say 99.5% of the people who drive on this street don't even notice this. It's cell phone towers camouflaged as trees. The indication of imitation is the things at the top called arrays. These are the things that help transmit signals to the cell phones, and as you can see, there's 2 of them right next to each other. To me, as I drove by, these trees looked unusual to me because I've noticed the subtle abnormalities within the objects. But like I said, I would say 99.5% of the people wouldn't be able to pick up on the intricacies. Why? Because they're not looking for them. They assume that these things are just simply trees. It's not like they're dumb, they just skip over the details. It's just that when you tell them, this is not a tree, this is a cell phone tower, they think you're crazy. This is a fascinating subject in itself. I think it's just some sort of cognitive dissonance mixed in with ego. People miss the subtleties, but they hate to be wrong. Now, I'm not saying that this next one is a UFO. I just want this to be an exercise in observing the subtleties in order to recognize the indications of imitation. And that's what I think truth is all about. If you search, you will find. Things won't be revealed to you unless you're really looking for it. If you're searching for the answer, you may end up finding it. And that's why I think we end up seeing unusual things, including flybys. We see unusual objects because we're the only ones that call for them. I believe that when we call for them, they give us clues and hints in order to reveal themselves to us. The probabilities of some of the things that we see are astronomical. Who catches the fish? It's those who bring the equipment. The hooks, the fishing lines, the bait. What happens if you see them without the equipment? You're probably getting lucky and probably, well, they trust you. But this is something that we'll talk about in another video. So let's get on with the exercise. What's wrong with this? Right off the bat, we're in the right place at the right time with the right equipment. We set the date, time, and place a month in advance. We put it on social media. We let everyone know that unusual things are going to show up. Also, keep in mind that we called for these things to come to our location. And this one showed up. For some reason, somebody spotted this one. This one I suspect was about 10 to 15,000 feet high, or about 2 or 3 miles. And there's no way we should have seen this thing up close. So of course, at first thought, these things look like balloons. Although that you could tell that it was a little windy up there because of the movement of the clouds, this one acted like there was no wind at all. The balloons weren't banging into each other, and you could tell that the tethers weren't like fraying in the wind. It was just rotating. I thought the color was a little bit strange. We don't see this color very often. They're almost like a wedding cluster. We just don't end up seeing this type of color very often. There were either 4 or 5 of them, but all of these tethers came to a certain point. And notice they all kind of stayed together to another point. But at this second point, something was like sticking out of the tether line. But also notice that at this protrusion, the tethers were kind of bent at this point, almost into an S shape. Whatever that protrusion was, it actually bent the tether line. This pop-out reminded me of one that we caught back in 2016, where this thing that looked like a number 6 had this like red inline spherical protrusion. I didn't give it a second thought, but it did actually alter the line of the tether. Anyway, this number six came and left and then came back again and then left. And then the third time it came back, it had popped. Now, generally, when balloons pop, the remnants head to the ground. This one didn't. Number one, you can't fake stuff like this. And what are the probabilities of you seeing something like this? Is it trying to tell us something? How come we were able to see this? Anyway, investigate. If you call and something shows up, videotape it. Even if it looks obvious, you have to scrutinize it. Yes, it's easy to blow things off like this, but don't. Look into it further. Who knows what you'll find? You just happen to be in the right place at the right time, set a month ago, and this thing shows up? You gotta look into it further. Also, sometimes when you're videotaping something obscure, a flyby will shoot right past it. Videotape them, no matter what. Now let's get into how I find out how high some of these things are, if the conditions are right. I use this free app, it's called Plane Finder. It's really a great program. It'll tell you which planes that are around you. But more importantly, it'll also tell you how high the plane is flying. Since we're about 8 or 9 miles away from the airport, we can see the airplanes ascending. On this day, there were a layer of clouds way up high, but I didn't know how high these clouds were. To me, they look like altocumulus clouds, but that would mean that they would range anywhere from 6,000 to 20,000 feet. Well, I watched the plane ascend until it disappeared into the clouds. Then I looked at the app and found out that it was about 20,000 feet. So they were probably cirro stratus clouds. So of course, the very next one that we saw, we were actually calling for, and we looked up into the sky and we saw one and it disappeared into the clouds, which kind of tells me that it had to have been around 20,000 feet. The one that disappeared into the clouds at 20,000 feet had to have been big for us to see it. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to capture it. Anyway, I hope you liked the video. Please like, share, and subscribe. I invite you to join LA UFO Channel on meetup.com. And I also invite you to one of our UFO sighting events. I think this year we're going to be traveling to different venues. It doesn't matter where we go, they show up. So Steven Spielberg, if you're out there, we could probably see them in your backyard. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time.